Good morning everyone, this is Ashok Kumar, Executive Director, Prayojana Construction Management Training Institute and Prayojana Engineering Services. The objective of the video is to give an exposure to prepare our internship report. I understand the people has went 2 weeks of training program including a field visits and the classroom training as per the industry norms. The five different topics we addressed is project planning, quantity surveying and estimation, the formwork technology and QAQC in construction and the site execution. We have took the students to 3 different projects. One is of a residential project at Chikmagaluru, second one is the highway project at Chitradurga, and the third one is in Alur Cross. There is a project of industrial construction. It is of Karnataka State Warehousing Corporation. I will start from the day one. What are the things we have undergone with you on this? One is the first day, it was an inauguration session. It was on 9th July 2018. Dr. Anant Raju was there and HOD was there. We were addressing about the importance of the internship, why a civil engineer has to go for an internship, what are the practical knowledges one should know before getting into the work. And the first day of internship, the topics covers is introduction to construction management, understanding the project construction and the scope of work. This session was taken by Mr. Sriraman and Mr. Ashok Kumar. And the topic covered is construction management. What is construction management? And how to understand the scope of the project of various domain in the construction. The related videos are available in the YouTube also. You can refer in our Prayojana Connect channel. Lot of videos related to scope of works, the sequence of construction is available. The second day of the internship, it was on 10th July 2018. The topic covered is type of structures and the sequence of construction for a residential building, for an industrial building, for an infrastructure project. How the sequence, each and every activity, how it is being planned, and we have made a detailed presentation for particular project, how the sequence will be arrived. Nearly 40 plus activities are there in construction. Those sequence it is in a classroom training we have conducted. Next topic was reading of how to read the construction drawings and understanding the engineering inputs from the drawing. What are the engineering inputs required for a site engineer once you get into the site? Those things we discussed in the classroom with the live project drawings. The third day of the internship is Mr. Sandeep Verma from Peri Formwork Technology. He addressed related to formwork. What is a formwork? What are the different types of formwork available, and how the schedule depends, between the schedule and the different types of construction, it is interlinked in the formwork technology. And the other session was with Mr. Prem Kumar. He was telling about how to prepare about the bar bending schedules from the construction drawing. We have given a practical drawings from the foundation for preparation of a BBS. It is called BBS. A quantity surveyor should know how to prepare the remove the quantity from the steel drawings or from the RCC drawings to exact quantify how much the steel is consumed. Any BBS BBS engineers are more in demand, and the quantity surveyor should know how to calculate the exact quantity of steel. And the third day was reading of drawings in the project site. We took you to the residential project in Chikmagaluru, and there we have shown about the how to read over the construction drawings. And Mr. Selva Kumar, structural engineer, he was explaining about the reinforcement details and bar bending system at the project site. The next day, the people went to industrial project. It is of Karnataka State. The client is Karnataka State Warehousing Corporation at Alur Cross. How the construction is happening over there, and what is the scope of work, how the industrial shed, what are the things addressed in the industrial shed. People took the notes also on that particular day, that roof is of truss type, and what are the ventilation systems provided over there, and the flooring, these things under the CC flooring around the shed. And the next day, our engineers went to Karnataka State Power housing corporation in Assam. They are advanced formwork technology called steel formwork, aluminium formwork is being used. It's a monolithic shear wall construction without bricks, without the blocks they are getting the construction. This is an advanced technology, and by using this technology the number of days we can reduce it and we can get a good finish. This was explained to the engineers. And there, inside the batching plant is there, how the concrete is getting mixed over there, and it's a modern batching plant. And the final day, the students were taken to Hospete Chitradurga National Highway Project. This is the highway project developed by Tata, and the contractor is L&T. 1500 crores is the total value of the project. And it is divided into three packages, and we went to the package three. There Mr. Prabhakaran, he addressed the students. There is a YouTube video available about the conversation about the particular project in the Prayojana Connect channel. The project manager has spent nearly 2 hours with the students on explaining about the how the highway is being constructed. You can utilize this material for the internship report preparation, because your internship report carries good marks also. Needless, all 90 or 100 students prepared the same the report according to your view. What you learned, you can prepare the report accordingly. Safety orientation being done at the project before entering to the other details. So first is preliminary, safety induction is given to the all the engineers. Next is quality. We went to hot mix plant. There the Linoff plant is there. The capacity is 200 tons per hour. And they stopped the plant. Our students went and seen how the hot mix is being prepared at the project, National Highway Project. And we went to WMM plant where the wet mix is being prepared. And the third one is batching plant. Our students went and seen how the concrete batching is happening. Apart from this, they went to precast yard and the QAQC. Quality assurance and quality control is very much important for any project. What are the tests conducted for the materials? What are the tests carried out for the construction, the process of construction? In every stage of work, what are the tests conducted? Example, field density, Marshall stability test, and the CBR. Like this, various tests. There is an in-situ laboratory at the project, and they undergone what are the tests conducted over in the project to get a brief idea about QAQC in construction. And there our civil engineers got knowledge from plant and machinery department head also, because for any major construction, mechanical engineers required, electrical engineers required apart from the civil engineers. So mechanical engineers and the electrical engineers, they explained about how the machineries are playing very much important role in the construction of a project in a faster way. Means these days any contract, it is the time is fixed. Because within the time frame, we have to complete the project in time. So we need modern equipments to construct the project within the time. Because within the time frame, that's this thing. We have given the cross domain knowledge about the plant and machinery and the electrical items which are involved in the construction. With this, we concluded the internship, and few students went to the project site in Sakleshpura also. They have done on-job training over there. They have also submitted an internship report for another 15 days that you can also refer. And there are 100 plus videos available related to project planning, quantity surveying, contracts management, and various parts of construction, including the highway. Mr. Prabhakaran has explained how the highway has to be constructed. Those things are available. This material will help you to prepare a nice report, because your report carries marks also. So if you have any doubts more over this, my team at your college, they will help you to prepare the report nicely. And all the best. I want everyone to get good marks in this particular internship program. Thank you, everyone.